Hey guys, how's it going? So in today's video, we are looking at another 2-in-1 convertible laptop from Acer. So it's Acer Spin 5, and this is currently one of the best-selling laptops on Amazon in the 2-in-1 convertible laptop category. So at the time of making this video, Spin 5 was selling for about $635 on Amazon. And this price actually, it has fallen down in the last 2 months, and it's significantly cheaper now than what it was back in January and December of last year. So here is the question. Is Acer Spin 5, is it a good choice if you are in the market for a budget 2-in-1 convertible laptop? To answer this question, I will take a closer look at all the key features of this laptop and I will spread it around 8 rounds. So at the end of this video, I will give my final thoughts. So let's get started. Okay, round 1. Let's talk about the build quality. Acer Spin 5, it has a 13.3-inch Full HD screen and its body is only 0.63 inches thick. The laptop weighs about 3.3 pounds and this is a little bit on the heavier side, I would say, especially for a thin and light laptop. But this is largely because it's made of, you know, full metal body construction. The chassis actually is constructed from real aluminium instead of some cheap plastic with metallic paint job, you know, which other laptops tend to do. So the top of this laptop, it has a brushed aluminium finish, which gives it a really clean look. It feels smooth to touch and it makes the laptop appear very premium. The rest of the body is also made from the same milled aluminium, but instead of going with brushed metal finish, Acer decided to go with matte finish. And I honestly prefer the matte finish because it helps with, you know, reducing fingerprint and the palm smudges. Acer has paid a lot of attention to detail. For example, all the edges on Spin 5, they are beveled and the seams have a tight tolerance, fit and finish. One of the most important aspects of any convertible laptop is its hinge. The hinge needs to be sturdy and reliable while also smooth and easy to manipulate. And this is not easy to do. So I'm very happy that Spin 5, you know, they have made a really nice hinge. It's actually a pair of dual torque hinge, which allows it to seamlessly transition from a traditional clamshell to laying flat on a table to tent mode and finally to the tablet mode. The hinge holds the screen very tightly and I did not notice any wobbling, you know, during typing or when I was using the touchscreen with my fingers. The screen was actually very stable. So overall, I think Acer has done a very good job and I am very impressed with the build quality of this laptop. Okay, moving on to round 2, and round 2 is all about the display quality. So like I said before, Acer Spin 5, it has 13.3-inch Full HD screen, 1920x1080p resolution. It's an LED backlit IPS panel and it supports multi-touch. The screen is plenty bright, it clocks about 280 nits of brightness. So that should be plenty good for everybody and you should not have any problem using this laptop in bright lit environment, you know, be it a classroom or a conference room. The contrast level is also good and the screen produces deep inky blacks. This screen has a wide viewing angle of 178 degrees. So that means, you know, the text and the images, they are going to look sharp even at skewed angles. The screen supports full Windows 10 multi-touch features. It supports an active stylus pen, but unfortunately, Acer does not include one in Spin 5. They have included one in the Spin 3 model, but for some reason, this model does not come with an active stylus pen. So I will throw a link in the description below of compatible active stylus pens that are going to work with this laptop. These stylus pens are perfect for students and working professionals who want to jot down quick notes. They are also good for sketching and drawing. Now, I'm not too fond of the big bezels on this laptop. The top bezel actually measures around 0.9 inches, while the side bezels measure little over half an inch. And while these chunky bezels, they definitely don't look cool, but they do serve an important purpose, especially when you use the laptop in tablet mode. This is because in tablet mode, these bezels, they are able to provide ample space for your fingers to rest without triggering any unwanted screen touch. Okay, now we are in round 3 and round 3 is all about the CPU. So Acer Spin 5, it comes with an Intel Core i5 processor. Specifically, this is the 8th generation Intel Core i5-8265U processor and this is from the Whiskey Lake family. So this is a 4-core 8-thread processor with a base clock frequency of 1.6 GHz and the max turbo frequency of 3.9 GHz. So this CPU, it has a TDP threshold of 15 watts. and it is able to automatically overclock from 1.6 to 3.9 gigahertz while still maintaining the 15 watt thermal envelope. So as a result, Spin 5 can deliver snappy performance while remaining cool. Now let's take a look at some benchmarks. So in the Passmark CPU benchmark, this CPU scores 7,989 points. And if we compare it with the top 10 common laptop CPUs, this CPU actually sits in the fourth spot and it's behind more power hungry and, you know, much higher clocked Core i7 processors. So for a thin and light 2-in-1 laptop, I think Acer has made the right call by going with this CPU. It gives good performance without sacrificing battery life. It handles day-to-day productivity tasks like, you know, running Microsoft Office, Outlook, word processing, you know, internet surfing. It is able to handle all those with ease. So overall, I'm very happy with the CPU performance on this laptop. Okay, we are in round 4 and this round is all about the GPU. So Spin 5, it does not have any discrete graphic card. Instead, you get an integrated Intel UHD 620 graphics. So most discrete GPUs, they tend to generate a lot of heat and that is not suitable for a thin and light 2-in-1 laptop form factor. But when it comes to performance, one should not write off Intel UHD 620 just because it's an integrated GPU. So if you look at some benchmarks, say for example, the DIRT 3 GPU benchmark, Intel GPU, it produces 37 frames per second and that's actually above the playability threshold, which is 30 frames per second. So that means you should be able to play all, you know, casual games on this laptop without any issues. And remember, the Intel graphics, it supports hardware acceleration for all popular codecs. So H.264, AVC, VP9, all these codecs are hardware accelerated. So in simple English, this means when you're watching 4K video on Netflix or on YouTube, you will have very smooth video playback. There will be no dropped frames and, you know, it will play smoothly. But guys, remember, this is after all an integrated GPU. So don't expect NVIDIA or AMD discrete GPU class performance. So if you guys are planning to do hardcore gaming, then I think you are better off buying a gaming laptop instead of this one. I have already reviewed a bunch of awesome gaming laptops on this channel and I will throw a link in the description and you can go and check out those reviews and make a decision based on those reviews if you are interested in a gaming laptop. Okay, now we are in round 5 and it's all about RAM and onboard disk storage. So Spin 5, it comes with 8GB of DDR4 system memory. Unfortunately, Acer has soldered the RAM to the motherboard and that really sucks. So that means there are no DIMM slots available for you to add extra RAM. Now 8GB RAM should be sufficient for most folks, but power users, they will be disappointed. It's really a bummer that laptop manufacturers have started soldering the RAM and, you know, not giving any DIMM slot. Their excuse is that, you know, it's a thin and light 2-in-1 ultrabook kind of form factor. But I don't buy it. I have seen some other laptop makers who have been able to provide DIMM slots even in thin and light design. So I am not happy with Acer not giving us any DIMM slot. Now when it comes to disk storage, Spin 5 comes with 256 gig of PCIe NVMe SSD. Now if you want to increase the storage, you will have to swap this SSD with a bigger SSD. And in order to do that, you will have to open the back of the laptop to access the M.2 slot. So I will throw a link in the description below of compatible PCIe NVMe SSDs that are going to work with this laptop. But remember one thing, before you replace the old SSD with the new one, you will have to clone it. So in order to clone your old SSD to the new SSD, you will need an SSD enclosure adapter. First put the new SSD in this enclosure and connect it to your laptop using a USB cable. Then using Macrium Reflect, which is a free disk cloning software, you will be able to clone the disk. So after you have successfully cloned your old SSD, you can remove it from the laptop and you can replace it with the new SSD. And that's it, you are done. So restart the Spin 5 and Windows will boot from this new SSD. So I will throw a link in the description to both SSD enclosure adapter and also the free cloning software and you can use that to clone your new SSD. Okay, let's move to round 6. Let's talk about the battery life and the thermal management. So Spin 5, it comes with a 3-cell battery measuring 4670 milliampere hour capacity. So Acer claims a whopping 13 hours of battery life on a single charge. But in my testing, I got about 8 hours of battery life. So I had, internet surfing while the Wi-Fi was on and the screen brightness was at 150 nits. Now 8 hours of battery, I think for, you know, a 2-in-1 ultrabook, it's not bad. It's pretty good actually. So say for example, if you are a student and you are planning to use this laptop in your classroom, the battery life is good. You should be able to use it for the whole day. I think Acer has done a good job with the thermal heat dissipation on this laptop. So after watching videos on YouTube and Netflix for more than half an hour, the laptop body still felt cool and I did not feel any, unusual heat or any uncomfortable warming of the laptop. Also, the laptop was pretty quiet. There were no loud fans cranking at full throttle. So the heat dissipation is pretty good. And this is, I think, primarily due to a well-designed heat sink and a cooling fan system. And I think Acer has done a really good job with the thermal management. Okay, now we are in round 7. Let's talk about the keyboard and the trackpad. Acer Spin 5, it has an island style keyboard. The keys are black in color and they have white lettering which is backlit illuminated. So the key travel distance, it's about 1.7 millimeters and they offer about 79 grams of actuation force. So this results in a very pleasant typing experience as the keys don't feel mushy and they give a nice tactile feedback. Now the keyboard deck, it's actually made of milled aluminium and it feels really comfortable when your palm is resting on it. I would say that for a thin and light laptop design, this is an excellent keyboard. Now talking about the trackpad, it's 4.1 by 2.6 inches, so that's pretty large, and you can scroll around comfortably. It has well-defined edges which will help your fingers stay, within the active area. Now this trackpad, it's not made of glass, but it still feels very smooth and precise. It offers 4 levels of sensitivity which can be fine-tuned in the software. The trackpad comes with Windows Precision drivers and handles swipes, gestures, taps, palm, rejection, it does all that really well. It also offers plenty of customization features, including 3-finger and 4-finger taps that you can map to things like, switching apps, switching desktops, adjusting volume, or launching, say, Cortana if you use Cortana. So I love these customization options. Acer has also included a fingerprint sensor on the top left corner of the trackpad. And this extra level of biometric security, I think this is a really nice welcome addition. Personally speaking, I am really bad when it comes to, coming up with a secure password, and I tend to forget complicated passwords. So I really appreciate a built-in fingerprint sensor. Okay, so we are now in the final round, round 8. And this round is all about the ports and also the speaker. So Spin 5, it has a dual front-facing speaker and they provide loud audio with decent bass. The speakers are hidden behind the grille at the top of the keyboard. I really like this placement of speakers because, the speakers are facing you no matter what the orientation is, whether you are in laptop mode or whether you are in tablet mode, the speakers always face you. So the maximum volume that these speakers generate, it's about 75 decibel. And even at high volume, I did not, experience any distortion. I think that's pretty impressive for an ultrabook because, these ultrabooks, they tend to have very tiny speakers. Okay, now let's talk about the port selection. So there is decent selection of ports on this laptop. There is a USB Type-C port and this port supports both display over data as well as power delivery. So that means you can charge your laptop via USB Type-C port. And you can also connect it to a compatible external monitor. Now, if your monitor doesn't support display over USB Type-C, that's not a problem because this laptop, it also has the old school HDMI port. In addition to these ports, the old school USB 2.0 port and USB 3.0 ports, they are also available. So plenty of ports. There is also an SD card reader, and this is great for people like me who take pictures and videos. So I'm very happy with the overall port selection on this laptop. And when I look at this thin and light laptop and when I compare it with something like, what Apple makes, there is so much difference, right? Apple will give you one USB Type-C port and that's it. So, I mean, Tim Cook, if you're watching this video, this is how you design a laptop, right? Nobody likes these stupid dongles. So you need to give all these ports. You can make a thin and light laptop and you can still give these ports. By the way, Spin 5, it also supports the newer Bluetooth 5.0 protocol. And that basically means that you will get really good quality audio if you are using one of these newer generation headphones. Okay, so after 8 grueling rounds, what do I think about this laptop? So for $635, Acer Spin 5, I think it's a steal. There are very few thin and light laptops available in the market at this price point, which offer comparable performance and features. The only 2-in-1 convertible laptop that I can think of is the Lenovo Flex 14. That's another very good laptop, and I have already reviewed that laptop on this channel. So if you are interested in that laptop, check out the links in the video description below. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below and I will try to help you guys. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out technopandareviews.com for more reviews focusing on laptops, gaming PCs, TVs, monitors, you know, gaming laptops and all these other gadgets. Again guys, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next one. Bye.